your lateral bend, your forward down, and you're stepping under with nothing on her. Okay? No pressure. So when we take the line off, obviously they're in a state of, well, I don't have to do this anymore. So we're really going to test to see if she's searching and wanting to please you and wanting to still perform these tasks. You will not have to do hunches. Okay, I know that we're still working through those little hiccups within understanding it with her in the teaching phase, but we will, the reason I have four cones set up, and we worked on this, now you don't know why, we worked on this prior to with our basic horsemanship 101 lesson. Let's start off with just leading beside, so we're gonna do it with a soft, a lot of these tasks, with this soft and light, I'll give you a short demo, soft and light a leader if possible, so that you're simulating very little contact, okay? So this is a, like I said, a real test of, has she really understood the concepts that we've been showing her? Does she want to work with us? Right now she would like to go investigate other things over there. So with our leading, first foundations are if I ask her to go, can she come with me? Hello, will she follow me? Good girl. And nothing has to be fancy yet, just will she come with me? Good girl. With as little slack or as little contact, sorry, as possible, the lead rope. And then will she stop with me? Good girl. So I just, we have our inner picture of the horse, nothing's changed. The one you had the lead rope with more contact. Our inner feeling is just relaxed energy. We have our whip to cue for forward. We have our whip to also cue for stop, okay? We have our voice if you want to use voice. You can use voice as long as you're consistent, okay? So quite often I use a tongue clip. So she knows that we're going to go somewhere. And I use woo. Apparently she's heard me teach before. Just kidding. So that way it just gives her a little bit more of a feedback. Yes, you're on the right track because there's no rope to tell her anymore, right? So we've got a nice stop and go together. I'd like to see, does she back up with you? Back. And if she doesn't back up with you, do you have a way of, good girl, communicating to her to back up? And then, come on, sweetie, let's go. One of the other things that we'll work on is as light as possible and as little contact as possible. Can you get her to move away from you? Oh, nice. You've done a nice job with that. So your foundation is all here for this anyway. So I don't want you to overwhelm yourself. It has to be perfect. Okay? Let's just have a little fun with this. And our end goal is once we've got our basics again, is that we can get her to guide around. Good girl. Can we get a little bit, without touching her, a little bit of LFS? We got locked. Good girl. Thank you for checking in. Like that. I'd like you to look at me and step under. Good girl. Look at me. Step under, please. Good, good, good. Step under. Look at me. A little more bend from here. I might have to yes, I like that. Thank you. Good girl. So like I said, your foundation's excellent. She's not going to be hard to do the prerequisites if does your horse go with you and stop with you. And she doesn't try to, I mean, well, I haven't tested her offline, but she doesn't look like she's going to try and leave me. But the liberty bending, walk on, please. If I ask her to step under a bit, good girl, and I'm going to reward her. Yes, good girl for looking at me. Love it. Step under a bit more. Good girl, but you got to keep moving forward. Can you step under a bit more? More hind leg. More hind leg. More this one. This one. Look at me. Good girl. Little more nose than I need, but I'm rewarding her every time that she's offering to check-in, which ultimately will be the start of, because I don't have an inside rein to pull anymore, hey? And this is a great opportunity to start with your positive reinforcement training as well. And have you used that for horse agility? Using treats? Yes? Okay. I believe we discussed that already, but I wasn't sure if you were still doing that or not. So in that moment there, I could, when I gave her that, yes, for me, that's my you got it cue, and good girl is you're on the right track. That's what I use. You can use what you like, just be super consistent. So when she looked at me and was stepping under, it was just a split second of being on the right track. So I'm like, yes, release, reward, relax, but the reward would be a goodie. Okay, give her a treat of some sort that she likes. So that way she's going to hunt it more. She's going to go, when do I get that magic clicker or word, yes, or good, whatever you use, just be consistent, like I said. And then she's going to hunt it. It'll be a lot easier for you, okay? So remind her to stay up with you. Do you feel her asking questions?
Yeah.
She's like, I don't know what we're doing. Yeah, see? That was good. That's your keep going cue right there, right? Good girl. Let's go. You got this. Good girl. So, I mentioned this to you in a previous lesson. Be your cheerleader. Like, let her know. She's on the right track. You're on the right track. She definitely wants to please you. But she's kind of an unsure horse. There's a licking at you. She's unsure. So, yes, I'd stop right there, actually, because she checked in. I just pedal. So a lot of this is about your emotional and your connection, right? So she's asking questions, and this is where you really ought to start going, okay, how can I help her? We don't want her to not ask questions. We want her to ask more questions. So when she asks questions here, give her that verbal dialogue. Yes, good girl. Thank you. And there she totally checked in. I love that when they do that. And that's when I say, we're getting somewhere. Good girl. Thank you. So I always say thank you. That's just my little thing. And I go, thank you for checking in. I love it. Good girl. And then she's like, oh, you like it when I'm like two-way street dialogue, right? I was two-way. She's like, okay, you weren't giving me enough feedback. You gave me the feedback I needed. Thank you, Leslie. What can I do for you now? Super cool. Okay, so let's go. Ask for a stop now and a backup if you're feeling confident with it, okay? So just walk a few steps and a stop and a backup. And she's asking questions though, so you could give her the whip cue to reinforce it, right? Don't leave her in the dark. You want her to be confident in her job. So right there, I'd give her a tap. Good girl. A little tap. That's nice. Good girl. And then a stop and a backup. Nice. And when your whip went up, you actually pushed your hip over. Okay. Do you have a good cue for the walk on? And you feel that uncertainty there yet? That's it. Don't leave her in the dark. Let her know. Yeah, let's go. Not polite. Yeah. That's nice. So you're giving her dialogue now. She's asking questions now. She's like, Are you sure? Yeah. You can also overuse your words. So you went from no words to continuous dialogue, and then back. Use your stick. You're cuter, but the hand can block the nose. A little tap on the chest. Yep, you're on the right track. Yes, okay, good girl. So now that you gave her better direction, we had a lovely backup. She's gonna need to be marching all the time. So we don't want her planting her front end, okay? So that'll be a little bit new for her. I'm going to walk backwards and get some movement in her feet. I'm going to ask her to step. Good girl. I just want to keep that march a little bit more here. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. She doesn't know. She's been planting her front feet for a long time. Good. And see how she changed eyes for me? So that's part of this, is just getting her here. You can just get her to flow nicely and then get on the other side, and then we'll try it on the other side as well. But it's nice that she completed the circle and gave me the other eye. Come into the hind end, good girl. But now I'm kind of drawing her at the same time, so you gotta have forward energy and yield. Yes, good, good girl. So that she's stepping but marching. So kind of scooping her in. It also helps you with your draw. So when on the circle there, did you, I was doing a little bit of that. So I was scooping, I call it scooping. Scoop them towards you. Here you go. Draw. Don't pull. Don't pull your horse. Invite her in with your belly button. Push that hip a little bit more. A little bit more. There, she's changing eyes. You feel that? Yep. And as soon as her mom gets coordinated with the whips, she'll be great. Awesome. A little more hip. A little, yes. Yeah, so now she's going to get stuck. And then just leave her for a second. A lot of this is you coordinating. Your horse is so adaptable. She's like, whatever. You just asked me different and I got this. Harmony in motion. Did you give her even a bit more line? And ask her to step under a little bit more. Good girl. And can you go to the next cone? And could she keep a little bit of that? Yeah. I like where you went with that. You're thinking that we still want that little bit of shoulder for the LFS. Doesn't have to be the perfect shoulder four, but if you get that little introduction of can you still bend, can you still step under, can you go to the next cone? Yeah, good job. Alright. Right there, you're losing the hind leg. Good. Now you lost the hind leg again and the shoulder came into you a little. Could you give it a little touch and say, get that out of my bubble. I don't want to get it out of your bubble. Yes, you can. What about the hind leg right there? Good. Yeah, there you go. The nose came to you, right? Good girl. Because I don't really want to. Lack of motivation in 30 plus temperatures. Ah, right there. Hind leg. Careful with the hand pulling her nose. A good girl. Is she giving you her nose? I would have given her a big praise, right? Captured that moment. You lost the moment, but next time she does that, give her a little tickle in that hind leg. Say, this one here, sweetie. Good girl. Also to redirect her, because where did her energy go for a moment? Did you see where she left you? She kind of checked out quickly. I don't know what's over there, but doesn't matter. Hello? Yeah, hula, yeah, her food. All right, that's fine. You just go, hello, back to me. Okay, so that's a great start, all right? Nice job scanning hind end and forehand, giving you a bit of bend. Careful with that. This side here is the side that she always falls in with her shoulder, hey? You can give it a little touch and say, nope. Do everything the same as if you had the cavesson on. Just except you're not touching the head anymore. Ah, right there. Give her a I would stop and pet her right there. Did you see that moment she gave you a beautiful curl? What a good girl. Gave you extra, right? So I really want you to capture those little moments where she goes from, well, I'm being very obedient and I'm searching for answers, but now she gave you extra. Nice. Yeah, no, it's great. That's what I want you to, I want to see you do more of is capture these little moments that are really good. And I think once you start introducing food at those really good moments, they'll come more often. Oh, look at this. This is nice, eh? Soaking it all in with you. Beautiful relationship you guys have. The essence of this, though, is not go do something. I like to think we're dancing together. Right, so I want that horse, I really picture that they're giving me that nice curve around me, and, you know, if she leaves, she leaves, okay? She might get more offended that this isn't a task where I have a very obvious obstacle, so it's a little bit tougher because now she's like, well, it's not obvious to me. That's why I'm getting you to patter at the tiny little wins, because like I said, obstacles are obvious. Go over the top, go over the box, go over the village. It's really easy to see it. They don't know what's here. It's really, we have it in our mind. Doesn't always mean it's completely in our mind yet. Okay? So take off your halter and your drop, and then you can pass it to me, and I'll just hang it up for you. And the first win is obviously that she doesn't leave. Can you rub her all over after I take this away? Just see what happens. Okay, so ask your horse to proceed forward. Oh, he's a good girl. Oh, we might leave you. I might not want to talk to you right now. Oh, that's okay. So how could we capture... Oh, maybe I'll go have a roll, she says. So let's be more interesting than our horse. Okay? So right now, she's in heat. She loves the boys. So I might just kind of get more life in me and go... The boys hold more value than you right now. So I'm gonna go, hey, how's it going over here? Great, some energy. Hello. How are you? Can I move your hind legs a little bit? Oh, what a sweetheart. Good girl. Thank you. Thanks for checking in with me. I got fun stuff for us to do over here. Hello. Good girl. Obviously she's planting. But she's not even thinking about drawing yet. I'm going to see if I can move her. No, wow, you got a nice turn here. So, can I, would you like to come back here with me? Good girl. What a store. So I was just trying to be more interesting. It's going to be really hard to be more interesting than the boys when she's in heat. But, can you come with me? Nice soft energy. Undemanding. So if you lose them, the two tools that we've worked on are, can you move the forehand and can you move the hindquarters? When you unlock the feet, they start going, perhaps you're of interest. And it's very undemanding. I didn't do it in an abrasive way. I don't want her running around. But the other thing you could do is, Genius, I came up with, like, hey, let's do some fun stuff. I'm trying to be like, yeah, this is great. You're going to look at me. Oh, you're a weird lady. But yeah, this is great. This is so fun. So I try and get them like interested in me. Like, hey, hi, good girl. So that snapped her out of her little high, her little sleepy state. Okay, so again, be more valuable or show more value to her than something else. You might even have to get some pom-poms out to be more valuable than a
treats.
Treats, exactly. Treats, but I don't have treats, so I just showed you a little bit of how I bring them back. I've just got some energy, and she's like, well, you look interesting. Good. What? Well, let's have fun. She's like, All right, so ask her again. If she leaves, I'm not going to fix it for you. I showed you how I play the game, and then we just go from there. We play it again. You play it again, right? She's like, what's in it for me? Good girl. And even basics. That's why I said just get the basics. Will she stop with you and get a bit? She's like, your diva's more interesting than you right now. Shh, don't tell your mommy. There you go over here. For a good weather scratch, maybe get more enthusiastic because you're very in the, I'm in a learning frame of mind. So you're like, you're focused. This is fun. I love Liberty. It's my favorite game. Okay, can you ask her to come forward again? So we at least have her come with me. Come with me, let's go. Let's go have fun. And then can she stop? Ah, give her a big, like, yeah, there you go. So be more enthusiastic for the simple gestures because they're easy to get when you have older. So I always break it back down that if they just stop with me, it's like a big yes moment again, even though it's something that you would expect that they should be able to do for the past 15 years of their life, but they did it for me with zero they're choosing it. Exactly. So I go right back to, wow, you gave me a tiny hindquarter yield. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. And they go, oh, all right, your standards are low. And I get big praise, but I get a different dialogue. They get more searching for me, right? Okay. Can you get her to back up 2 steps without facing her? Give her a weather scratch with her. She checked it. Just say, hey, good job. Oh, I look at her face. All right, and back up 2 steps. And she wants to leave. So what could you do with her hind legs right now? Say, hey, can you look back at me, please? Where are you going? Nowhere.
What is she doing?
Nowhere. I'm not going anywhere. Good, and let's ask her to back up again on this side this time. Can you use your whip? you could put that out in front of her a bit more. Now yield her hind limb. Just yield, say, hey, hey, hey. Just softly, softly. Draw her back in. Draw her back in. Good girl. And then ask her to yield her hind end again. She looks like she's going to come and visit me instead. Hi, how's it going? Would you like me to do the program with you? I want your mom to be of more value than me, okay? Over here. Let's go. No idea why she's locking into me more, other than, and I see your dynamics just changed too, but again, you're in a different energy because you're a warning and I'm on camera. And she's like, ah, Diva's in her natural, calm, goofy state. So I'm going to go. Yeah, she likes goofy. Yes, she is. Well, I can see she's just like, Esli, you're too serious. The Diva looks like one. Right? Good. I would already tip her hind end a little bit. Say, where are you going, sweetie? Hello? Because I'm, you know, my brain's down here. There's my shelter. Good girl. She checked in. Get a little bit of pressure on the hind leg and see if it'll move over for you. I use a good girl. Yeah. So yeah. Where's the treats, Mom? Good. And then just gently, you know, give her release, reward, relax, and love, and come back and just gently, even if you do a circle right there, it really doesn't matter about the cones, right? It's principles of the purpose of the task, right? Will she offer to do a circle? And if we get one for today, she's all done. She can go roll and flirt with her fellows over there. And that would be the ultimate release. Good, I love it. And then you lost her. Hey, you got half a circle. And now the weeds are more interesting than Leslie. Yeah. Now, the barrels are interesting. You got a half a circle. That's okay. That's okay. Don't put too much pressure. Breathe. Breathing. Relaxing. Smiling. Smiling. So another thing I always think of is as soon as they look at me, even though they don't see smiles like a human sees a smile, I think it changes my energy. So anytime a horse looks at me, I smile at him. I put a big smile on my face. It works for me. And they just go, oh, the dude is happy with me. Nice, good. And then just draw backwards. See if you can just yield her hind end and come to you. Yes, yes, and then pet her. Fantastic. It's a win for today, okay? It's going to be a really fun change for you too, because I can see that's what I was concerned about, is that although you have a fantastic foundation laid for levity, she's like, I just see sand. I don't see obstacles. Therefore, we're done. There's nothing interesting here. In a straight line, can she stop? Can she back up? Can she mirror your steps there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Good girl. Nice. Can you walk forward again? And if she leaves, can you catch her eye? Like, yeah, I'm back. I'm going to get out of the arena because she's magnetizing over to me here. I'll get out of the way. Less distractions.
Nice. The nice thing is you can keep bringing her back when you lose your attention. So just flow. I want to be able to see that you can catch her when you need her. Bring her attention back. Looking for her to search for answers. And then give her a rub and let her know she's wonderful. She's like, yeah, I know. I'm very smart. Good girl. That was a nice draw. All right. Good. Give her a moment. Give her a scratch. I like the turn away on that one better. The one before, she was more planting her hind end, and that one's leading to more thinking way in the future. But a pirouette, the horse doesn't plant its feet. But the main thing here is that you have the ability to move her shoulders away from you. First of all, safety too, obviously. You can adjust your shoulders and move them away, and she's very good about your bubble and your inner picture, right? So that's, you've done well with that. And you're getting her to come back. She was very aloof, not interested in sticking with her human without the halters, so it's come a long way. Yeah. How about the hindquarter yields? I see that you have them to catch her attention and bring her face back, but what about more of a structured turn on the forehand, when ideally they're not planting their front feet? Yeah. So you just need to move her like one step forward and then switch your whip over. Good. She only needs to move a step forward, then switch your whip into your new hand. There you go. Until she gives you the other eye. She's giving you the other eye. She's giving it to you. Let me show you one of those. There you go. So you want to get it, but then draw back and she gives you the other eye.
Right.
Yeah. And, you know, just walk a few steps forward here and then ask for it again. This side now. Think about driving that hind leg away. Does it move away from you? Good. There's your other eye. So allow it to happen. And now walk on somewhere. Ah, that was nicer. So start your circles. Inner picture. And don't lead her with the hand too much. Thinking more of, could I tap her shoulder lightly to get that shoulder to be hollow, more hollow. Good girl. More hind leg. More hind leg. Good girl. And don't bribe her with the other hand. A little bit further away would be lovely, thinking of the same thing we would do if we're working in hand. She goes, well, never mind. Is that an eye? I'm going to go check it out over here. It looks interesting. You could clap your hands and make a noise. Ah, see, that gave her more interesting. So something over there is more interesting than you. As soon as she looks at you because you're making interesting noises, go, yeah, thank you, good girl. So I'll sometimes make a quick sound or clap my hands so that they look at me and go, oh, you're more interesting than what I just caught my eye. Our goal in the arena is we're more interesting than everything else. It's not that I'm dominating you in here. I just want to be more interesting. Will you stick to me? Because I got fun stuff to do. Really picturing that beautiful circle around you. I'm going to go visit the water trough. That's it. See, she got... Whoa, what? Oh, hi. Good girl. Nice. I wanted to go visit the dog in the water trough. Switch the tools again and see what you can do. It doesn't matter if the circles change from left to right. We'll just play. No structure, just what are we... Yeah, good girl. That one was really nice. Very nice. Could you ask for more hind leg right there? That'll also help bring that nose to you, hey? Dog's in her water trough, so that's very interesting. Good job. Catch your eye. Lots of licking and chewing. And could you move that hind leg a little bit more? There you go. Very nice. Good job. And she says, I'm out of here. I did a circle. Something over there is far more interesting than us. She always comes back to you though, right? So that part's going really well.
She just doesn't see, like, well, you know what? It's not really all that interesting doing these circles. So perhaps more praise and enthusiasm, you know, for the basics. We did a whole circle. Very nice.
Yeah, good girl.
Exactly, right? That's good.
Good girl, that's it. You got it.
Now we're talking.
Yeah, there you go, buddy.
And then give her a break. And give her lots of pets. Because that was two circles where she just, you were finally more interested in the dog in the water trough and whatever's going on at the other end of the arena.
Yeah.
So just give her a nice big scratch all over. Really nice developmental. So what's definitely going really well is that you're, she comes back to you every day. Yeah, she does. I'd like to see, one of the things, I think the reason she leaves is she's feeling that you're pressuring for too much perfection.
Yeah.
Right? And I think that's the root reason why she goes, nah, I don't really need to do this right now. So that's why I give you the tip of, let's say you're really enthusiastic, you did one circle. And my other tip is if you have really good control of that hind leg, they automatically bend, which then gives you the eye, which then prevents it from leaving the circle. Yeah. And you already have that instinctually from, like, you're drawing her in. But that circle's kind of a draw in, too.
Yeah.
Right? Draw in, but you're too close. Now draw in, but you're too close. It's that fine balance, right? So those are my tips for the Liberty work. I'd like to just see the other side and see if you can apply those tips. Okay, so you're not being such a perfectionist. and really being enthusiastic and using your voice cues and maybe more breaks when she does it right, like we did just here, too. Circles were great. And let her know, wow, that was amazing. Because she's like, you're asking for too much and I don't need to do this. It's not going to be as perfect as we have it with Lido. As long as she keep trying and looking at you, I'm thrilled. Okay? Yes, you're a good girl. All right, let's do the other side. And what about the hind legs? Could you yield the hind legs and make noise, maybe?
Until you catch the other eye. That other end of the arena is fascinating. Good. Oh, all right then. Are you more interesting than what's ever over there?
And again, remember that hind quarter. Can you get the other eye even, or suggest that she moves the hind leg? Good. Nice catching her attention. And I would do, what would you do right here? What should you do? Love it, thank you. Because
she came back
and gave you the circle, yeah. We just gotta drop the perfectionism. They're leaning into you too, that's nice, right? So that, say thank you. And then just tinker with another one. Everything's coming together really nicely.
Very nice. I love that you checked in. Very nice. Super. Love it. Just leave it at that. Yeah, and a nice head down at the end. Well done. Oh, and a big snuggle. Oh, that's beautiful, Leslie. Great progression, hey? Very cool.